Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Sofia Goyal and today we are going to discuss this very very important topic
about polyfill for bind. And if you don't know how to use call, apply and bind, you can check out my previous video. I can put the link in the description box below. And before going further friends, I would really request you to please subscribe the channel for these educational videos and please don't skip any bit of this video so that you can get a better understanding of this and you don't miss any important information whatsoever. Fine, so without wasting any time, let's start the video. So first let's know what is a polyfill. What is a polyfill? A polyfill is a function which is created, you know, as a replacement to an existing function to make it compatible with all the browsers. Okay, so what happens is there are some functions which are created later on or like which are created earlier maybe, but they are not compatible with all the browsers. Most of the things are not compatible with IE, you know, like the older versions of IE 9, 10, 11, or sometimes these functions does not have the functionalities that all browsers support. So what we can do is we can create a polyfill of that function. So that will be, you know, working as the replacement of the existing function. And we can, you know, put the functionalities that are not currently supported by that function in the polyfill. Okay. Now, don't be confused with the polyfill of bind. Like I'm not going to put any extra functionalities in that. This is just to check your knowledge whether you can create such type of replacements or not. Okay, so that is the purpose. I want to create a my polyfill function which should serve this functionality, right? So what I can do is function dot prototype dot my bind, okay, is equal to, now obviously this is a function. Okay, so basically if you have to create a function, a replacement function, or if you have to create your own function, you have to create it as a prototype of the function object. Okay, so if you don't know about prototypes and everything, I will be creating a separate video for this later on, but as of now just think about this way. Now again, this should be a bind, should be a function because clearly this is a function, right? So that's why we have created it as a function. Now, as I have already told you that what bind does, it basically returns a function because this bind name is a function. So what we can do is return function. Simple. So till now it is very simple. Like we are creating a function, a bind function. So that's why we have taken it as a function. And now it returns a function. So we need to return this as a function. Okay. So that is the main thing. Now in this function, like in the bind function, we pass the object to define the scope of this, the context of this. Okay. So what I can do is I can pass something as object here because this is the bind function. Remember, this is the bind function and this is the function which it is going to return. Okay. So this is the function actual. So here we have passed this object. Now what I want is, okay, now on the function on which I'm going to call this bind, how can I, you know, refer to this function? I can refer to this function using this. Okay, I can, you know, get the reference to this function using this. Fine. But here I can do is const func is equal to this. Fine. But obviously, because we need the scope of this here in this return function, that's why I have created this constant func to keep the scope of this in the func. Otherwise here we will be losing the scope of this. Fine. And now what we can do is, I think it, you know, you just think about it. It could be simple for you. What can we do to, you know, attach the scope of this to a function? What we did was call. We used call, right? What we use call for? We use call to attach the scope of this to a function. Simple. I hope you have got getting this. So function dot call object. Okay. Now, if I try to replace this bind with my bind, what I can see is John Doe. Yay, we have created a my bind. Okay, I hope you are happy with this. Now comes the thing is when we were passing city to this, how we are going to do that? Because it is not accepting any external argument. So this function is still not complete for us. Okay, so what I can do is, for example, this is using city, and now again I am just arranging it lives in. Lives in city. Fine. Now, for this to call it here, okay, let's see what happens here when we pass the city here, like Delhi. Okay, so this is what is the return function. Okay, so we can pass the arguments here. Okay. Yeah, so what we can do is with the call function, like we have call and we can, you know, just simply pass the arguments here. Okay, so if we pass the arguments here, what we can do is we can check, like, see, this is John Doe lives in Delhi. So this is the way we are passing the arguments here. But again, another thing comes up is, what if I want to pass some arguments here as well? How I'm going to access it? Okay, so here I can do this as pass it as argument, and let me name it as arguments 1, and this could be arguments 2. Fine. Now what I need to do is I just need to combine these both of these arguments, and I want it, you know, to be passed as single thing here. So what I can do is I can do this apply, and I can create an array where I will be spreading these arguments. Okay, args 1 comma args 2. Fine. So here if I try to do this with my city 1 and city 2 example, let's leave Bangalore out of it now. So lives in, let's leave grammar out of it now as well. Fine. So city 2. Fine. So if I'm passing here as Mumbai, so let's check it out. What is the result? John Doe lives in MU. Okay, I think I've done. Okay, sorry, I forgot to spread these out here. Okay, we need to spread the arguments here as well, and then basically we are combining it. If you know ES6, you would understand like what is happening here. So if I check it out now, I can see the result. John Doe lives in Mumbai, Delhi. So friends, that was mainly about how to create the polyfill for bind, and we have covered, you know, pretty much everything that is required to create a polyfill, and I hope that, you know, you have got a good understanding of it. I have tried to, you know, explain everything in that function to you from a very basic level, so that you know, you don't need to just mug it up. You can understand and create it whenever it is required. And if you have liked this video, please press the like button. Please tell me in the comment section about it. And please subscribe to the channel. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.